want no more.
Fine girl, no pimple. Give me your intro. Give me that info. I want your controls.
Entertainment enthusiasts have on many occasions observed that news of challenging government is widespread in the media about Nigerian music industry, artists and their activities. Many fans of the artists have also expressed concern that the causes of the trending news originate when some of the artists find it hard to understand the trend and supply sounds useful for the growth of the entertainment industry. They argue that with young artists focusing on good music, gossip both online and print media are becoming unattractive to a credible industry, making Nigeria proud on the world stage. Kelvin Sean is a Nigerian hip-hop artist telling the world it's time to change the game and make sense for the growth of the Nigerian music industry.
Well, I mean, it is challenging for sure. There are lots of obstacles and lots of challenges you face as an Afrobeat musician in Nigeria. The industry is structured in a way where, you know, you have to break through. So you have to really work hard to get that. I mean, I think we all have to support each other one way or the other. And I think it doesn't always have to be about money. It has to be about the love of music in general. So, I mean, we have to support each other in every department. And that way we're going to make things better for our sound and our industry.
For Kelvin Sean, the current gossips and beef in the industry did not represent what it takes for Nigerian music scene to be highly rated with the right accolade. But he feels the industry has developed tremendously.
It's come a long way, obviously. We're worldwide, we're global, Nini Gang, you know? So, Afrobeats is well and widely accepted all over the world. So, you know, it's a worldwide thing.
While observing further that the real problem among the artists is the absence of clear-cut distinction between Nigerian music scene and business, he has words for upcoming singers struggling to survive.
Trust me, I go give you my heart.
Social media is amazing. Like, a lot of people broke out on social media without even going to the studio at all. You know, they never recorded a video or an audio, but they did a video like on their cell phones, posted it on YouTube or on Instagram, and yeah, someone like Davido calls them and, you know, signs them up. So social media is great. I mean, record executives are now on social media looking for the next big thing. So I mean, you can promote your music without paying people that much money by just, you know, doing a social media campaign or whatnot. So it's very helpful for upcoming artists and even for the successful ones as well.
He says the government should realize that there ought to be an understanding that beyond the art and passion, the music industry is guided by economic support, which must become the priority of politicians.
I feel like government funding will be very important for upcoming artists. I mean, like grants, government grants where an artist can pitch in a project and get a grant from the government to fund that project. And also, I mean, like just loudening it for the people, like the government can come in and, you know, just make it big, just take it to the next level. But all the same, we as artists, we're doing the work and we're taking it worldwide.
As expected, he condemned piracy as major cancer destroying the industry, but never failed to regret that some artists prefer their songs being pirated to become famous.
As musicians, when you put in a hard work or you put in sleepless nights into your craft, you want to get the rewards for it. So if it's being pirated, I mean, it's kind of like you're working at a loss, and that's not good for any working man or woman. Again, I feel like the industry is structured in a way where even artists pay people to pirate the music. So, I mean, restructuring is very important. I think we're going to get there, and I think we should get there to get to the next level, if you know what I mean. We have to go right into the roots of the problem, which is like it's a problem. That didn't start today. It's been a problem for a long time. And I mean, digitally, as an industry, we've made a lot of strides to get our content online, you know, digital distribution. I think we have to do more of that to get away from the piracy. You know, as artists, we have to work hard. And when we put our stuff out there, we have to make sure it sells and not just pay people to pirate it and sell it.
He speaks about his next project while promising to help the Nigerian music industry grow.
Well, like I said, positive energy. I feel love is very important, regardless of the situation, regardless of the society. I feel we as humans have to love each other. We have to express it to each other, and we have to be empathic to our situations as well. That way we actually do better as people.
The Nigerian music industry comprises companies and individuals that earn money by creating songs, the organizations, the associations that aid and represent creators and sellers of such musical materials. He argued that although Nigerian music scene has companies, groups and individuals involved in the music making process proper structure, accountability and data required for a flowchart to work like well-oiled engines are needed to take it to the next level.
Yeah.